cooking, Appa?
Hi, this is cooking, Appa. Today, Appa is going to make sesame oil chicken. Ma you ji. Okay? So, I will guide you through some of the things that you need to be take note of when you are cooking this particular sesame oil chicken, because there's one thing about sesame oil. It is, if you cook the sesame oil for too long by itself, it will turn bitter. Okay, then the whole dish become bitter. Okay, so that is one thing you need to be very take care of. And today, Appa is going to use the KS chicken from Kisong. So why is it Appa always use KS chicken? Is because most of the time, we really want to know what exactly are we eating, especially when we are cooking at home for our family. So what kind of KS chicken are we actually eating here? It is actually organically farmed. It is actually fed with lactobacillus, which is something like a yogurt drink, yeah. And it has less fat and cholesterol, and it is farmed without using any growth hormone and without any antibiotics, right? And it actually also listened to Mozart music. Now, this thing about Mozart music, I saw some of my followers, they become very amazed by it. And they are really wondering why. Why do Kisong let their chicken to listen to Mozart music? Actually, when the chicken listen to Mozart music, it is actually meant to calm them down. Okay? If you can probably relate, if you have gone to any chicken farm before, it is super noisy. The chicken there is very noisy and keep on shouting and things like that. And by giving them the Mozart music, they will become a lot more calm. Okay? So, I'm actually using the lector chicken here, which is the thigh. Yeah, this is actually the thigh. So they got many different parts. Of course, they got the chicken, they got the whole chicken, they got the leg. Yeah. So I'm using one pack of thigh here, which is called the thermal pack. Very, very convenient. When you frozen it, you just take it out and you want to use it, just to defrost it, put it inside the water, and the water will not go in, right? It is very, very nicely packed and it saves a lot of space. I have some extra, this is cut out from the whole chicken, one piece of chicken wing and one chicken thigh. So all together, plus this is about 400 grams, this is probably about 150 grams. So I have plus minus about half a kilo to 600 grams of chicken here. Okay, and this dish, basically you just need a bit of chopped garlic, a bit more julienne ginger, right? Up to you. You can choose to make it very, very fine, or you can do it a little bit thicker like this. Really up to you.
Remember to click subscribe and notification button for more Appa's video.
Okay, let's marinate the chicken. I have cut the chicken into a bigger chunk here. I think I have at least 600 grams here, good for about 4 person. So let's give it about two tablespoons of light soy sauce, some Shaoxing wine. Of course, if you don't take alcohol, just skip the wine. And I'm going to give it a bit of sesame oil. Sesame oil here will actually pre-flavor it. This is actually supposed to be sesame oil chicken, yeah? Okay, and then of course, if you want to let it marinate inside the fridge for some time, 1 or 2 hours, also can. Today, Appa is not going to do that. Already very fragrant. Okay, let's get yourself a wok. And now the first thing you can do to avoid your sesame oil become bitter too easily, it is to give it a bit of sesame oil, about 1 to 2 tablespoons, mix with vegetable oil, then it will not get bitter so easily. Mix it, yeah. Of course, next thing is to saute the ginger and the garlic. Actually, this dish is super easy but super, super yummy. It goes really well with white rice, especially with the the sauce later, yeah, the gravy. Oh, it's now already super fragrant because of the sesame oil. All the ingredients that I use, I will actually, including the chicken, everything, how to where to buy the chicken, KS chicken, and also all the other sauces. What are the sauces or the ingredient list that I use? I will put everything inside the video description or video caption. Just check it out. All right. Then put in the marinated chicken. We are still on medium high heat right now. Oh, super fragrant, man. Now we can actually add some seasoning. Let me tune down the light a little bit. Oops. Some oyster sauce, about 1 to 2 tablespoons. You can tune down the fire a little bit while you are doing this. And where's my lights? First, 2 rounds of lights, soy sauce here. Some Shaoxing wine, of course. Some dark soy sauce for the color. About 1 tablespoon. Now you can tune out the fire. Oh, smells so good. Add some hot water. Why hot water? Because during cooking, you try not to reduce the temperature of the cooking, yeah? But seriously, if you don't have boil or hot water, then just put room temperature. All right. Before I let it simmer, I'm going to add a bit of salt and sugar. Right. Bring it to a boil. It is now boiling. Close the lid. Close the lid and tune down to medium to between medium to medium low, and let it simmer for approximately 15 minutes. Then it is done. Simple, right? Of course, towards the end, we can add a little bit of sesame oil. Okay, this after approximately 15 minutes under low medium heat. Simmering, you can see the broth has started to reduce. Now, it's really up to you whether you want to starch this or not. I'll probably starch just a little bit. Half the fire, just give it a full stir. Done. Of course, this is sesame oil chicken. I'm going to add just a little bit of sesame oil before serving. Okay. Super fragrant. I'm going to dish it out right now. Alright, so here's my sesame oil chicken. I'm going to garnish it with some fresh coriander on top. Done. Oh my god, I'm going to eat a lot of rice tonight. Okay, I hope you like my video. Now, few things here. Number one, do not just stir fry or cook the sesame oil by itself for too long. It will actually get bitter. Okay, so mix it with something else. And number two is let it reduce. Let it simmer for approximately 15 minutes to let it reduce. Then all the gravy will become thicken out and then get absorbed into the chicken. So I hope you like my video today. If you like my video, do share my video out on your Facebook to your friends. Come Cooking Apa Facebook fan page to click like and follow button. Follow up on Instagram and subscribe to Cooking Apa YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye.